Biophilia.
Well, it's her vision that we're putting on the screen, really. So, you know, she artistically leads the whole project, and we're just trying to interpret it for the big screen.
You produced a documentary about Björk pretty much 10 years ago. Mm-hmm. Do you remember when you first discovered her and her music?
Yeah, I mean, well, you know, from day one, I knew, you know, from debut onwards, really. But I really became a fan around the Vespertine album. I saw her perform it at the English National Opera. And just desperate to document it, so I called her manager. I had no relationship at that point, and just said, please, if you're going to film this, can I be involved somehow, and can I, you know, find a director and put it together? And that's what happened.
Oh, and what kind of relationship do you have now?
Well, yeah, I mean, over the years, kept in touch, you know, and when I saw that Peter's film, The Bearing Sound Studio, it just sent off all kinds of sparks, and I just thought, you know, really visually intense film, really rich sound design, hang on, that could really work with Björk, you know, being such a boundary-breaking artist, such a boundary-breaking director. So I just gave them a shout and sent the film over, and she really liked it.
She's so unique and singular and completely self-sufficient as well, and independent, and doesn't really give a damn what others think.
How do you guys work together? Like, what kind of roles do you have?
Headlocks, rugby tackles, that's usually how it works.
On each other's knee.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, no, we collaborated very well on this. It's been a real pleasure to work with Peter.
There were some very special instruments. Could you just give us one example?
The sharpsichord was my favourite, by Henry Dagg. He's from Kent, and I think Nick actually described it really well. It's just kind of this gigantic music box, this steel music box, which you can turn around, and it makes this incredibly kind of melancholic sound, which I really enjoy. It's this colossal thing, you can't transport it beyond the UK.
It's really exciting to have the film at London Film Festival, because the film was filmed in London at Alexandra Palace, and obviously it's an amazing film festival, and I've had a couple of other films here, and it's always been great. I had Depeche Mode 1 and Uncle Teenage, and so yeah, really excited to have its UK premiere in London at London Film Festival.
We are on the brink of a revolution that will reunite humans with nature through new technological innovations. Until we get there, prepare, explore, Biophilia.